Hey everyone, welcome back to Loja YT. Today we are going to create some amazing stuff using Element 3D, which helps us to add 3D object in a video. The Element 3D is a 3D compositing plugin available for After Effects only. Now let's move ahead. First, open After Effects. Create a new composition. Name the project. Let us name it Adding 3D Model in After Effects. Okay. Now let us import a video from Pexels. I have imported this video from Cotton Bro. Now drag the video into the composition. Let us stream the video now. In the video, the woman is wrapping some gifts for someone. Now let us make her parcel a skull too. So here we go. The trimming looks good to me. So we will place a skull in the area on top of the ribbons. In order to do it, now track the scene. Right click on the footage, go to track and stabilize. Select track camera. You can see here After Effects has given us lots of tracking marks after tracking the whole footage. The tracking marks are assigned to all the contrasted spots, and if you link any layer on top of it, they will react with the movement of the tracker marks. As we have decided to place the skull on top of the ribbons, now we are going to select the tracker points which are on top of the ribbons. Click and drag over all the tracker marks that are on top of the ribbons and make a selection. After making the selection, right click and create a solid with camera. This will assign a solid layer on top of the area. And here you can see the green layer is already reacting with the scene. Now as the tracking is done, now let us bring the 3D model into the scene. To work with the Element 3D, create a solid layer. I'm going to name the layer as Skull. Okay. Now to add Element 3D on the scene, we are going to Effects and drag Element on the solid, which will create a 3D universe for us inside After Effects. Now here you can see the scene setup. Click here and a new window will pop up. This is how Element 3D interface looks like. We will make a detailed tutorial on Element 3D in near future, but in this video we will show you the basics and the things you need to know to add a 3D still object. Now import a 3D object which will have OBJ as extension. I have downloaded this skull from Free3D. The link to the website is on the description. You can check it out. Now moving forward, after importing, a new window opens up for further settings. Click on bottom and press OK. Here you can see the skull on a plane. Now you can adjust size, alignment and so on. Here you can see the skull. There are lots of options to adjust size, adjust alignment and so on. Let us adjust the alignment now and add a plane to make an idea how the skull will look like on the main video. Now Our next step is to go to auxiliary animation and assign it to channel 1. Okay, now here we go. We can see the skull is already on top of the footage, but notice now the skull is flying without any surface to react with. Let us increase the size first. It's still small. Well, it's still small. We will adjust the size later. First, let us give the skull some surface to be on, right? So next, we will go to element layer, go to create group null and press create. This will create a group null layer on the timeline. Remember, we have created a solid which was assigned to the ribbon area. Yes, we are going to link the skull to the layer. So click on the transformation properties and copy the position values from the track layer and paste it on the position values of newly created group null layer. Here we go. Now the skull is clearly reacting with the area we wanted the skull to be on. The skull is tracked nicely and is moving smoothly, and now we can adjust the size of the skull. So let's work on it. Go to element layer and click on particle look. There will be size properties, and here you can adjust the size of the skull. Let us increase the size a bit. A bit more. Looks perfect to me. There are lots of options to work on 3D object, which we will talk about later in another video. Here you can see the skull is successfully placed in the video, but it does not look legit. So let us add some light to the skull in order to match the video ambience. Now go to the layer, add light. We are going to select the temperature. Let's select it from the video. Okay. We are going to add some light on the right hand cheek of the skull. As you can see, the light in the video is coming from the right hand side. Looks like as if there is a window from where the light are coming. Next, we will go to the transformation values of the light layer. Click on the light option. Here we are going to increase the intensity. Here we go. It is already looking good and blending well with the video ambience. So I hope you enjoyed this video. In coming videos, we will talk about how to add lights, detailed tutorials on Element 3D and more. Till then, stay tuned for more videos. Hope this video was helpful to you. And if you want to have some demands for us, please comment it down, and also comment if you have any queries about this video. Thank you for watching the video.